Terraform for Java developers. I am Julien Dubois. You can follow me on Twitter at Julien Dubois, and I am leading the Java Developer Advocacy Team at Microsoft. Today, we're going to talk about Terraform, which is a tool that many DevOps people like, but which can be a little bit frightening for Java developers. So we are going to introduce it through a Java developer's perspective, and we're going to do 4 videos, and you are currently in the first video, which is the introduction to Terraform. We are going to talk today about what Terraform is, how you can benefit from it, and we will start a very simple project with Terraform. And then in the next videos, we will go deeper into Terraform, create a MySQL instance, have a look at best practices and tools with Terraform, and how you can run your full Java application on the cloud, thanks to Terraform, of course. So let's get started and describe a little bit what Terraform is. So Terraform is a tool by HashiCorp. It's open source. You've got an enterprise edition if you want very advanced features, but for usual people, especially for Java developers, you will not need this. And Terraform has got support for most public clouds, including Azure. So as I work for Microsoft, I will use Azure here. But all the concepts we are going to talk about are the same for all the clouds. So that's one of the first interesting features about Terraform, is that if you learn Terraform, for example, here you learn it with Azure, well, then you will be able to reuse that knowledge on another cloud. So as a developer, it's very interesting for you because you will not be tied to a cloud. Well, for the implementation, you will be tied to it, but for the concepts and for the usage, you will not be tied to a cloud. So that's very interesting for a developer. Then, second thing which is interesting about Terraform is that when you start working with a cloud like Azure, so let's just go to the Azure portal here. Well, when you start working with it, you're going to use the portal like I'm doing here, and you're going to click around like here. If I want to create a resource, I'm going to say Azure database for MySQL, and that's how I can create my MySQL instance. And I can do this here by clicking around, but very quickly, you will see that this usage is not very good because you cannot reproduce it. You cannot share it with your colleagues. So it's good if you want to create a MySQL instance for one time, but usually as a developer, that's not what you want to do. And the portal will not be enough for you. So very quickly, you will want to script what you are doing. So for that, you will want to use the command line. And so Azure provides a command line like here, yeah, like az, MySQL, and well, let's just type alpha to have some information about this. And as you can see, the command line is very complete. It tells me, okay, I can use MySQL server, and so on and so forth. That's a good way, well, that's a better way to create your resources than going through the portal. But as you can see here, it's pretty manual. And also, well, you need to run the commands. So if I want to share this with a colleague, well, I need to give him all the commands that I've used. You can't really, well, you can program some things if you use it inside a bash script, but you can very quickly see that it's going to be annoying and complicated to reproduce. And you will not have also good understanding of what you have created. You will not have a state of what in your cloud, you will just have commands that you run one after the other. So Terraform is a different tool. So Terraform is a tool that gives you a state of what you have created and allows you to describe it and to update it. So let's get started by a very concrete example. I'm going to use a classical Spring Boot project, which is called the Spring Pet Clinic. So this is done by the Spring team. It's not done by HashiCorp or Microsoft. It has got nothing about Terraform yet. And we're going to take that project and create some Terraform configuration for it. And in the meantime, I will describe you what Terraform is good for, how you can benefit from it, and how it works. So let's first fork it. Well, I've already forked it, obviously. And let's now clone it. So if you follow that video, I encourage you to do the same as me, because honestly, it's very easy to do. And it's not going to cost you a lot of money. You know, we've got a big free tier on Azure, but even without a free tier, thanks to Terraform, you can very easily create your resources and delete them. So that's also why using Terraform is going to be good for your bill. You will very efficiently and very easily create and delete everything. So here is my project, it's available here. I'm going to open it up with IntelliJ. And so that's a very classical Spring Boot project. You can run it using Maven. You just do a Maven Spring Boot run. Here it is. And you can have your project running. That project will work here locally on my laptop without me running any database, because you've got two profiles for the Spring Pet Clinic. The default one, which I'm using here, uses an embedded H2 database. And when you go to production, well, you have a specific Spring Boot profile, which is here, MySQL. And this is what you will want to run into production. So with Terraform, what I want here is to have a Java server running that connects to a MySQL server, and I want to configure them to work together. So basically, I will need to transform this file into something that works with Terraform so that I have everything running in production. Let's just have a look quickly at the app that is running currently in development mode. So here is the application. So you can find pet owners here. And this comes from the database. So you can see I have my Java server running and my database running together locally. Let's get started with Terraform. So let me just go back here. We can close this now. And the first thing I'm going to do with Terraform is create a directory to work in. I'm going to call it Terraform. That's the first good thing we can see here with Terraform is that my configuration, my description of my infrastructure is going to live next to my code. So it's interesting as a developer because you can have a look at what you are going to use, how it works, and you can, of course, tweak it. But also it's interesting because it's inside my project, which is stored in GitHub. So I can fork it, I can clone it, I can tag it, I can merge it. So I have all the goodness of Git, which is available now for my cloud infrastructure, which is a lot better than when I was typing it on the command line. So I'm going to create a new Terraform configuration. I'm going to call it main.tf. So I'm going to add it to Git, and that's a Terraform file. So you can see we've got a little icon here. So that's another good thing with Terraform. Most IDEs have got support for Terraform, so I'm going to have auto-completion here, which is awesome. For this first video, we're going to do something very simple. I'm only going to create what we call in Azure a resource group. So a resource group is where all my resources will live, including my Java server and my MySQL database, which we'll do in the next parts. And in order to create that resource group, I'm going to use Terraform. So for that, first thing I need to do is create a provider. We've got providers for all the big clouds, including two providers for Azure, which is a little bit surprising. So Azure is the older one. Azure RM is the newest one. So that's the one you should use. And so here you describe the provider you want to use and you give its version. So the current version at this time is 2.20.0. Of course, if you watch this video, there will probably be a newer version available. And now that I've said I'm going to use Azure, I'm going to create my resource group. So everything we're going to create here is a resource in Terraform. And that resource has got a type. So type here is resource group. And the resource group has got a name. So you can put the name you want. I'm going to call it example because we're doing an example, but this is free, of course. This resource group has got two attributes for the moment. The first one is location. So that's where my resource group is going to live. As I'm in West Europe, I'm going to use a West Europe Azure data center, and I can name it the way I want. As I'm just playing around, I'm going to call it TMP Spring Pet Clinic. Those two attributes are mandatory for me to create my resource group. One good practice I'm going to tell you right away is usually I like to add a tag here and to tag my resource so I know it's being created by Terraform. So I'm added a tag. So this is totally free, of course, but I like to tag my resource so I know that I'm using Terraform here. So then I can filter my resource group and know which resource groups I manage manually and which ones I manage using Terraform. So this is my Terraform script to generate a resource group. Now let me go back to the command line. Let me go to the Terraform directory that we have created. Here is my main.tf file. I'm going to use the Terraform command line to generate my infrastructure. So I'm going to call Terraform. First, Terraform init. So this is to initialize Terraform. What it's going to do is that it's going to download the provider, so the azure provider that we have just configured. It's going to install it. And as soon as Terraform is initialized, I'm going to be able to use it. So the first command you can do is Terraform plan. So this is to ask Terraform what it is going to do. So currently there's nothing and it's going to create a resource group. So it's basically going to tell me that it's going to create the resource group that I just configured, but it's always good to know that. So as you can see here, it's going to create my resource group. It has got the parameters that I have given, but also there will be some new parameters like the ID of my resource group, and you will only know it once your configuration has been applied to Azure. So let me apply it. Terraform apply. It's going to run the plan again. It's going to ask me if I'm okay to do that. You can force it, of course, but it's more secure here to have a look at what's happening. You can see plan 1 to add, 0 to change, 0 to destroy. That's probably something you want to look at when you perform an action. And I'm going to tell it yes. And this is going to create my resource group in Azure. That's, of course, the easiest thing you can do with Azure. Let's just have a look in the portal. So if I go back here to the Azure portal, if I go to resource group and I refresh, and here it is. So here is the resource group I have just created. It's empty at the moment. And we can see it has got a tag, Terraform true, which is a tag that I have just configured before. And so I have created my first resource with Terraform. If you want to know more about deploying our Java application to the cloud using Terraform, well, please follow the next videos. We are going to create the MySQL database that will be needed by our application. Thank you.